Well, hello, and welcome to another episode by Financial Ernie. On today's episode, we're going to be talking about Sowgood. That is a freeze-dried snack company. We're going to go over their latest earnings reports. We're going to talk about some of their quarter three highlights, as well as the full year highlights. And then we'll key in on a couple of the key phrases that the CEO did mention during the earnings call. So without further ado, let's get right into it. All right, so on November 14th, 2024, Sowgood did release their earnings report. It highlighted what their revenue was for the quarter. It went over some of their gross profit margins. It also had some interesting information in terms of inventory levels. And also, it gave us some insight onto what exactly slowed down that revenue growth that we saw quarter over quarter in the earnings reports before. First thing I wanted to mention, this is actually part of their press release that was coupled with the earnings release. They did mention that they had their sixth freeze dryer come into full operations. So that helps them increase that inventory per month that they can get out to their various retailers and distributors. One thing that is also worth noting is they did mention that they are currently only in about 10% of the total market for this freeze-dried candy segment. So there is quite a bit of room for them to continue to expand. The inventory level growth has to do with the fact that they did decide to pause shipments over the past quarter, and that was due to the extreme heat they saw in Texas, as well as the fact that many of their distributors did not have air-conditioned controlled locations to store the product. So for that product that experienced some of that extreme heat, the Sowgood executives have been working diligently to get that product taken off of the distributor shelves for the ones that did go ahead and stock that quantity. So looking at the earnings highlights and lowlights, we'll start with their revenue. So they did see a drop in revenue. As mentioned, quite a bit of their product was put on pause. They did not distribute in this past quarter. They had a total of $3.6 million in revenue compared to a year ago revenue at $5 million. That was a decrease. They did provide this update. And if you did listen to the earnings call in the previous quarter, they did talk about the fact that they were going to have to pause some of their shipments. So this should not have came to a surprise for any of the Sowgood investors. We'll talk a little bit about what happened with the share price as well as we continue forward, but let's go ahead and jump into some more of the financials. Next up is the gross profit margin. You could see for this past quarter, they had a gross profit margin of $600,000 compared to $1.3 million in the same period in 2023. So they did have a significant gross margin or gross profit margin reduction. And they did talk a little bit about that. It had to do with the cost of goods, the higher cost related to their new facility. If you have been following their press releases, you would also notice that they did go ahead and sign a lease for a larger facility to go ahead and help them as they continue to scale up. So as you may recall, they do have a total of six of these freeze dryers, and they have planned in 2025 to have an additional maybe five or so of these come online. So they are planning for some substantial increase. And if you look at, again, their overall market, they're only at about 10%. You can actually go on their website. You can also look at some of their investor presentations and see a list of all of the current retailers that do have their product. They have retailers such as Target, Cracker Barrel, Five Below, Albertsons, and a few others on their current list. And they are actively reaching out to additional retailers to try to increase that market share. So the big surprise that may have caught some of the investors off guard was the fact that their diluted earnings per share was a lot lower than what was forecasted. Even with the baked in earnings per share being reduced due to the pause in shipments, they had a negative 0.33 cents diluted earnings per share. Also, their adjusted EBITDA was at negative $1.9 million compared to the previous 2023 quarter at 0.6 million, so 600,000. So they did see a decrease. Again, this should not be, you know, too much of a surprise considering the fact that they did pause shipments. So their revenue did come in a lot lower compared to some of the cost of operations but we'll go ahead and look over some of their inventory levels as well. All right, and looking at the inventory level, again, this is from the SEC filings of their 10Q. You can see that they have a total inventory on hand currently at 19.4 million. This is compared to the 2023 quarter end of only 4.1 million. So they did continue operations. They did generate quite a bit of additional inventory. And this gives them the opportunity as they start to get into those additional markets, those additional retailers, they already have that product on hand to be able to start stocking those shelves. And again, this is going to be just a cash transfer as the majority of the G&A and other items for this specific inventory has already been taken out in this previous quarter. And one last item I did want to talk about is going to be their cash on hand. You can see they ended the quarter with $6.9 million cash on hand compared to a year ago at $2.4 million cash on hand. They did have a little bit of a drop on cash on hand compared to just a quarter before. However, they did decide to go ahead forward with an at-the-market offering. This was actually launched on November 14th, the same day as earnings. And if you look over some of the off-market transactions, you can see that there was already about 1.5 million shares traded off exchange. And if you read through their prospectus, you can see that they were planning on about a total of 2 million shares for this additional or for this initial at-the-market offering. So it does look like they've already exercised quite a bit of that just in that first day. They did go over exactly what that would do to share prices in terms of dilution. As you recall, prior to the earnings, if you look on the 13th, the share price was sitting somewhere between $9 and $10. Since then, the share price has dropped into the $4 and at some point sub $4 range. Again, if you look at that at the market offering, you look at the calculation for dilution based on the amount of cash they were planning on raising, it did get that price down around that $4.25, $4.30 range. So that is something to keep in mind. But there were some excellent highlights during the earnings call. I did want to mention just a few of those as we continue. All right, and if you listen in around the 10 and a half minute mark on the earnings call, you're gonna hear the CEO talk about their intentions of getting into the international market as early as 2025 with plans both in Europe and the Middle East. Also on top of that, she also mentioned about a specific PO that was actually just placed with Toys R Us Canada for some additional product as well. They also mentioned scaling up their marketing and their sales teams. Again, if you think about it, they only have a 10% current reach in this market for this share of candies, specifically the freeze-dried candies. So there's definitely some opportunity to expand into some additional retail networks. And scaling up for that with the inventory they have on hand all makes a lot of sense in my opinion. There was also the Halloween as well as the upcoming Christmas spend in terms of candies and things of that nature. So I will be interested to see how those newer SKUs actually come out. They have been putting out some newer innovative SKU items as well over the past few quarters. So again, looking at the inventory on hand, looking at the fact that they are scaling up production, and looking at the fact that they are starting to source some of their own raw materials, gives them better opportunity to have increased profit margins. However, you do have to understand that they did have to learn from this extreme heat situation. So they will be shipping a lot of their product in some conditioned transportation vehicles. And then they are also going to ensure that their distributors and retailers do have air conditioning controlled storage locations for their products. It's going to be important that they don't impact any of their sales for future quarters to come. And they also talked a little bit about some of their sale velocities. Although their gummy worms, those freeze-dried gummy worms did experience a slowdown in sale velocity, they did have some of their other SKU items pick up some sale velocity, looking at some of their spheres. They have some sour as well as some sweet products. Again, those are more of those hardened type candies, similar to Skittles. So those actually held up just fine in this heat condition. So I do think they are going to be pivoting, and they're going to be learning from that. I also think that they've gotten quite a bit of money from a cash on hand standpoint from this at the market offering. I will be interested to see when they put out a press release announcing that this at the market offering is completed. So a lot of future information, a lot of opportunities in this market. If you look at the current price, I am not going to state any type of price targets. That's just not what I plan on doing on this channel, but I did want to just mention that this price was largely impacted due to this at the market offering. So again, if they have some significant news, if they have some positivity in the upcoming quarter and future quarters, I do think that you will see some investors come into the Sowgood ticker symbol and pick up an investment. That's just my opinion. This isn't financial advice. That's just my thought process. And if you have also been following the freeze-dried candy overall market, you would notice that there are some larger name brand companies that are trying to get into this specific category by, you know, actually getting into the freeze-dried industry. So that actually shows that there is a strong market demand for this product line. I know you will hear some people say that this is a very niche type of situation, but I do not feel that that is the case. If that was the case, you would not find these larger name brand companies trying to get into this industry. Also, there is a pretty good social media presence involved in the Sowgood brand, and there's been a lot of very positive reviews around this specific product. So again, looking forward to seeing how they are able to capitalize on that inventory they have on hand and on that additional freeze-dried equipment. With all that being said, I hope you all really enjoyed this video. If you did, consider giving a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, drop a comment, let me know your thoughts about this video. What do you think about Sowgood as a brand? Also, what other kind of content would you like to hear me cover in videos to come? And with all that said, I hope you all have a great rest of the day, and I'll see you on the next one.